my family. My wife and I have 5 children, 4 sons and a daughter, and I lost 3 sons, and I lost my wife and brothers. And what happened to my family shouldn't happen to anyone's family. And that's why I've been going around the country the last 14 years or so, speaking to young people, really at the most important time of their lives. In high school, was when you make some of the most important decisions in your life. Kind of hard to believe, but this is the most important time of your life. This is the time you make decisions affecting for the rest of your lives. Decisions regarding education, sexuality, lifestyle choices, smoking, drinking, doing drugs. When the people start smoking, they don't start at 45 or 65. They start young, high school, sometimes even younger. When the people start drinking alcohol, they don't start at 60 or 70. They start young, high school, sometimes even younger. And drugs are the elementary school or not, schoolyard today. So a young person has to be a lot more aware, a lot more conscious, a lot more intelligent than they've had before in the history of mankind. This is the most important time in life. This is the most important time in history in so many ways. Time to make more decisions that such an effect on your lives. You have to be careful about that. You have to be wary about that. You have to be very intelligent about that, about making choices this time in your life. It will affect not only you, your generation, but your future generations, your grandchildren, your great-grandchildren. I realize, of course, I look out on you because I'm old enough to be your grandfather. I'm 72 years old. I have a granddaughter, 27, so she's a high school teacher. And I think about it, I think, I realize, of course, that your parents probably know about me, your grandparents, I don't know that many young people do. So in order to make my presentation, I bet you should follow up and show me a video, which kind of encapsulates some of my boxing history, all my family history, the last 45, 50 years.